So, good evening, everyone. I wanted to thank President Fenton for that kind introduction and to welcome you all to this fascinating program hosted by the American Academy of Arts and Sciences on the topic of redistricting and representation. The Academy, under Jonathan's leadership, has sponsored so many different exciting programs, ranging from philosophy to science to law to nuclear war to education, and I just heard, to citizenship. Name a cutting-edge topic, and the Academy is addressing it. Today's topic on partisan gerrymandering spans issues of law, mathematics, and policy. This program is not about an esoteric or geriatric topic, but one that is on the front burner of the Supreme Court in the landmark case of Gill versus Whitford, which was just argued a month ago before the Supreme Court on October 3rd, 2017. A split three-judge federal district court in Wisconsin had invalidated a redistricting act passed by the Wisconsin legislature on the ground that the Partisan Gerrymandering Act violated the Constitution. Particularly, the court found that the act was intended to burden the representative rights of Democrats by impeding their ability to translate their votes into seats, that it had its intended effect, and that the plan was not explained by the political geography of Wisconsin and was not justified by a legitimate state interest. That was a split panel with a dissent. There was a four-day trial. I like to point this out as a trial judge, sort of what the trial judge did, held a four-day trial with eight witnesses. He wrote an enormous opinion. The dissent was enormous, and now it's on appeal. This was the first decision in decades to reject a voting map as an unconstitutional partisan gerrymander. So as background, as you'll hear more about in tonight's presentations, the Constitution requires that states make a good faith effort to achieve one person, one vote. When I studied in law school, it's one man, one vote, but they've changed one person, one vote. Most of you know that. In addition, as you probably know, the Constitution and the Voting Rights Act prohibits racial gerrymandering. But what makes the Gill versus Whitford case so interesting and unusual is that it involves partisan gerrymandering, which means, loosely speaking, the common practice of the party in power to choose the redistricting plan that gives it the advantage in the polls. The Supreme Court has tackled this issue before in fractured decisions and rejected such challenges, but some justices always left open the possibility that such challenges were justiciable and manageable. The debate before the Supreme Court was robust. You can get it and read it or listen to it online. So is this an equal protection problem? Is this a First Amendment question involving freedom of speech and association? Are there metrics, like the so-called efficiency gap, which some people call EG, that make it feasible for federal courts to decide? What other metrics can you use? At oral argument, Chief Justice Roberts worried that the Supreme Court would have to decide in every case whether the Democrats would win or the Republicans would win, and worried that this is going to cause very serious harm to the status and integrity of the decisions of this court in the eyes of the country. I don't have the answers to this question, but luckily, we have our wonderful panelists who will address these issues. We will hear remarks from Gary King, Jamal Greene, and Moon Duchin, followed by an opportunity for question and answer. We will adjourn strictly, I'm told, at 7:15, unless I forget this giant sign that goes up that says, "The End." So because we're on a tight schedule, I was actually chosen not for my great wisdom about this partisan gerrymandering. They wanted a trial judge who could give people the hook. And so I will reserve the right to control the Q&A so that as many people as possible get a chance to speak. I will ask everybody, and I'll remind you of this, to get up and give your name and ask just one question. And then we'll move on to a discussion, hopefully, over here about the question you've asked. Again, this will be streamed. So let me do the introductions all at once. Let me begin with our first speaker, Gary King, who is the Albert J. Weatherhead University Professor at Harvard University and Director of the Institute for Quantitative Social Science. By the way, the bios are in your materials, so I'm only doing a quick synopsis. He develops and applies empirical methods in many areas of social science research, focusing on innovations that span the range from statistical theory to practical application. He has served as the president of the Society for Political Methodology and as vice president of the American Political Science Association. He's been a member of the senior editorial board at Science, visiting fellow at Oxford, and a senior science advisor to the World Health Organization. He's had too many articles and software packages and books to list. He's an elected fellow of the National Academy of Sciences, and he was elected a fellow of the American Academy in 1998. Jamal Greene is the Dwight Professor of Law at Columbia Law School. His scholarship focuses on the structure of legal and constitutional argument. Professor Greene served as a law clerk to the Honorable Guido Calabresi in the United States Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit and for the Honorable John Paul Stevens, who sat on the Supreme Court. He was an Alexander Fellow at the New York University School of Law and a Leo Gottlieb Visiting Professor of Law at Harvard Law School. He is the author of more than 30 law review articles and is a frequent media commentator on the Supreme Court and on constitutional law. And Moon Duchin is going to teach us some statistics. She is an associate professor of mathematics at Tufts University and director of the Science, Technology, and Society program at Tufts. She launched the Metric Geometry and Gerrymandering Group, a team of mathematicians working to provide geometric and computational solutions to redistricting in the United States. Her research interests include geometric group theory, the history, philosophy, and culture of science, and gerrymandering. She is a fellow of the American Math Society and has won so many awards. So I am now going to sit down. We're going to turn this over to the experts, and then we'll have an opportunity, as I mentioned at the end, for Q&A. Professor.